Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video. And there's a reason why I'm starting the video off like that, and that is because I've bought a graphics card from the one and only RandomGaminginHD. And in fact, it's his old AMD RX Vega 56. A graphics card which I think is pretty cool. I think the Vega lineup of graphics cards from AMD are seriously underrated and overlooked by a lot of PC gamers. AMD just did a lot of cool stuff with these things, and they are actually a tweaker's dream. And for their price, they perform pretty well, and because they're overlooked as well, you can pick one of these up for around £89, which is what I bought this one for, and it will get more performance than something like a GTX 1070 or a 1660 Ti while costing less. And the model I've got here is the MSI Airboost, and it is a blower style card, which I know isn't exactly ideal for a 210 watt TDP card, but it actually did remain pretty cool and pretty quiet, hovering around 65 to 70 C under load. But I know why it's done this, because I think I accidentally left it on the silent BIOS instead of the performance BIOS, as this thing does have two BIOSes enabled on it. But for the £89 that I spent on this graphics card, I don't think the specs are too bad, with 3584 shading units and 8GB of HBM2 memory, which is incredibly cool. And the main difference between HBM and GDDR memory is the fact that HBM is located directly next to the GPU die. This allows for more bandwidth and insane memory buses at 2048 bits, which is absolutely insane. And this is mainly down to HBM just being incredibly close to the GPU cores. If you look at a regular graphics card, they'll have memory chips dotted around the PCB, but HBM is directly next to the GPU die, and this allows for much better memory bandwidth, especially back in 2017. I have done some benchmarking, but this isn't actually a benchmarking video per se. As I've said, I did kind of leave it on the wrong VBIOS, which did result in lower performance than what I was expecting, which isn't exactly representative of what this graphics card can do. However, I will throw up some graphs showing how well it performed, and it was a bit off a 1660 Ti, so it's not terrible performance, but I know it can get around about 5 to 10% more than a 1660 Ti at stock settings. So if I had the performance VBIOS enabled here, I'd be getting much better performance. One game which I thought performed kind of poorly on this thing is Cyberpunk. I don't quite know why it's done this, but it just about broke 40 FPS on the medium preset, which is not what I was expecting. I was expecting slightly better performance here. And when I was going outdoors, it was closer to 30 FPS, which is never ideal in a gaming scenario, because 30 FPS isn't good. Also, Call of Duty did exhibit some stutters as well, but I'm not sure if this was down to the Vega 56, because it was updated recently for the new boys update, and that apparently just wrecked performance on PC in general. So yeah, take that with a grain of salt. As I previously mentioned, when I did my testing with this graphics card, I was kind of scratching my head at why it wasn't performing as well as a 1660 Ti. And the main reason for that is because I was using the wrong VBIOS on it, which was, pretty embarrassing. I'm not used to dual BIOS graphics cards, as I don't think I've ever actually owned one before this, so it was kind of a new thing to me, and I sort of just expected out of the box it was going to boost up to the highest frequency, which was 1622 or something like that. But it was hovering around sort of 1200 to 1300, and I did some looking into this. I knew it wasn't temperature related, because it was hovering around 67 degrees C, so it certainly wasn't temperature. And it dawned on me, what if it was power? Here I looked and I noticed it was actually a dual BIOS graphics card, and I even looked in MSI Afterburner, and the power limit was at 100. This is okay for most graphics cards, but the power limit can be increased by 50, which is insane, and I do believe this would result in much better performance. And me being on the silent VBIOS does kind of make sense, because the graphics card was running suspiciously quiet for a blower style card. So for future testing, which I'll be doing in a different video, I will be using the performance VBIOS on it, so you can see how well this graphics card actually performs, because to be honest, I kind of kneecapped it in this test. So alongside the VBIOS, I can also raise the power limit in future testing as well, so the graphics card is going to get the full power that it deserves, and this will result in it running very hot and loud, but it's an open air test bench, and I've got a 650 watt power supply in my test bench as well, so power's not an issue, cooling probably won't be an issue, and we'll see how well this thing actually performs. So bearing this in mind, the future plans that I've got for this graphics card are, as I've just said, I'm going to test this properly with the performance VBIOS and the power limits turned up, so I'm not going to be sandbagging this thing at all. And as the HBM2 memory in this thing is made by Samsung, which is what I'm led to believe is the best manufacturer for HBM2 memory, I can actually flash the VBIOS on this thing to a Vega 64. This should net around 10% more performance, and yeah, 10% more performance, I will take that, thank you very much, and I can get some decent content out of it as well. So if you want to see that here on the channel, make sure you stay subscribed, turn on that notification bell, and leave this video a like. So to round off this video, it's been a bit of a short one, and it hasn't been very substantial, if I'm honest, that's the way I'm feeling, but it was supposed to be a benchmarking video, to be honest, but then I was an idiot and used the wrong settings and the wrong VBIOS, and it would have been pretty misleading to say the RX Vega 56 isn't actually that good because I was using the wrong settings, if that makes sense. And I also bought this graphics card from RandomGaminginHD. He was a massive inspiration to me at the start of my YouTube career, and yeah, he's inspired me to make this sort of GPU content and PC gaming content, and I haven't looked back since. Overall though, the thoughts on the Vega 56 are pretty positive, to be honest. I was kind of disappointed when I saw the performance, but I know this thing can perform much better than what it was performing today. And that's a good thing, because I know this graphics card is like a tweaker's dream, so a lot of content to look forward to with this thing, and hopefully I can get it performing better than a GTX 1070, because I know it can. And it's not just the performance out of this thing as well, it's just a cool graphics card. Like, AMD was like, no, we're not going to use GDDR memory for this, we're just going to slap some HBM2 in there, and it's stuff like that which is just insanely cool from this era of GPUs, but GPU manufacturers now are too busy just giving you rubbish value on your graphics card, so yeah. With that being said, I'm going to leave this video here. If you enjoyed this one, leave it a like, leave it a comment if you really enjoyed, and stay subscribed for more tech content, and I'll catch you in the next one.